edition of UNIMED Career Updates. It's a program of the University of Medical Sciences, UNIMED, Ondo City, Ondo State, here in Nigeria, where we showcase various academic programs of the university. My name is Temitope Oluwatayo. Let's meet our guest for the week.
Our guest on today's edition of UNIMED Career Update is Dr. Oyetunde Oyeyemi. Dr. Oyetunde Oyeyemi is an associate professor in the Department of Biological Sciences, University of Medical Sciences, Ondo City, Ondo State, Nigeria. He holds a PhD degree in zoology and specializes in parasitology. His research activities are focused primarily on epidemiology and control of transmission of parasitic diseases. Dr. Oyeyemi is a fellow of Nigerian Young Academy and African Scientists Institute. He is widely published and he reviews for many reputable journals. He is a beneficiary of few local and international research grants and several international travel grants. He was awarded the Best Researcher in 2018 and Outstanding Researcher in 2022 at the University of Medical Sciences, Ondo. His long-term goal is to be a research champion in Africa who will facilitate drugs, vaccine, and efficient diagnostic discovery against tropical parasitic diseases.
Glad to have you on this edition of UNIMED Career Updates, Dr. Oyeyemi.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Sir, let's start from your constituency, animal and environmental biology. Can you tell us more about this program?
Thank you once again. The program Animal and Environmental Biology is a branch of life sciences that has to do with study of animals and the interaction between animals and the environment. And when we talk of animals, it could be microscopic, those we could not see with naked eye, it could be those we can see with naked eye. It could be wildlife, it could be domestic animal, even it could be human being. So study that encompasses all of these range of organisms, that is animal and environmental biology.
Okay, sir. So what are the career opportunities for this program, sir?
Before I will talk about the career opportunity in the program, I would love to talk about the various branches in this program. Okay. So that will shed more light about the prospects, this course. The first one I'll be talking about is ecology and environmental biology, which has to do with the study of the relationship between animals and the environment. When we talk of environment could be land, could be water, could be air and the like. So people in this branch of study, they are furnished with knowledge that involve remediation of environmental issues, for example, pollution and the like. So you find people in these areas, vast with knowledge on how to remediate, environmental issues, especially pollution. So people like this, they are often employed in the oil industry, they are employed in the industry. In fact, all industries should have an environmental biologist because they are to foresee, they are to evaluate the environmental impact of any activities going on in the environment. Whether in the industry, beside the pharmaceutical company, they have to project what impact that company will have on the environment. So in many other industries, almost all industries must have an environmental biologist. Then I'll talk about parasitology, which happens to be my own area of specialization. We talk of parasite, they are microscopic animals, rather than animals. So when you talk of animals, you think is a gorilla, lion, and the like. But we have some animals that are microscopic in nature, which are pathogens of infection. They carry germs that cause infection in human. So somebody in this environment, that's more or less medical related. So they are vast in knowledge related to disease control and the like. And you find people in this area, working with WHO, working with many non-governmental organizations like SiteSaver. I have a lot of colleagues working in the with SiteSaver, a lot of them working with the public health organizations, working with Ministry of Health, either federal or state Ministry of Health, and so on. Then we have fish and agribiology. It's a very wide course, so we have, and I can keep on talking and talking and talking.
That's what this program is.
So, talk of fish and agribiology from the word fishy. Agribiology simply means it has to do with the study of lakes and the water body. Talk of organism, animals in water, and the relationship between this organism and, you know, condition of water. And of course, these people also involved in remediating, you know, aquatic pollution, because they study water condition, water quality, and the like. And also in aquaculture, in fact, a lot of graduate of, you know, animal environmental body can stand, you know, alone, you know, because they are furnished, you know, with knowledge on how to raise, you know, fish, you know, how to maintain fish, when you know, condition in which, you know, fish can thrive, you know, you get better yield when you, you know, breed such fish. So we have a lot, you know, of course we have a lot of fish farmers in there, but, you know, these people who are going to, the graduate of are going to, you know, do fish farming in a better way, because they are furnished with both theoretical and practical knowledge, you know, of how to, you know, maintain healthy fish. And also many other, you know, companies that have to do with fish, they can be easily, you know, employed in that environment. Then we have entomology, study of insects. And we talk of insects are of both, you know, agricultural importance and medical importance. So if you focus on the insects that are of agricultural importance, of course, will be relevant in agricultural farm. You know the biology of insects. From there, you can go on, you know, to even develop insecticide against such, you know, pests, you know, that are of insect origin. So you can stand alone by even synthesizing pesticides, agrochemicals, you know, to farmers and the like, apart from even securing job, you know, in the agricultural firm. Then we talk of a set of medical importance, like talk of the one that carries a malaria parasite, mosquito, for example. You know, those ones are, you know, important. You know, they are relevant. They can work in medical settings. Even WHO, okay. Some research institute, the medical research institute, employ those people because they have understanding about insects. They can, you know, look at host, you know, parasite or pathogen relationship. And don't understand the biology of insects, may not be able to even develop drug or develop even insecticide that will be able to, you know, kill that insect. So it is these people, you know, that, you know, such organization we love to employ. So we have many other talk of genetics, bedrock of all science, you know, very relevant in every field, whether agriculture, whether medical setting, talking of gene therapy. You know, you talk of, you know, manipulation of gene, even in agricultural setting to produce, you know, improved variety. The work of animal breeding, you know, it's work of experience gotten, you know, from genetics can even help us to boost, you know, agricultural produce. And you find that these people are relevant in almost every sphere of life, whether agricultural setting, medical setting, and so on.
There are two things I'd like to pick from here, sir. One is very, very key here. People don't want a program they will study and they go back looking for a job at the end of the day. From what you explained, there are many opportunities available for this program. But how easy is it to stand on your own? I think that's what many of the viewers will be interested in.
Oftentimes, you know, when students are seeking for admission, say, I want a professional course.
Yes.
I want a professional course. And what is a professional course? A professional course, you know, to a layman, that is a course that when you finish, you'll be able to stand on your own. You don't have to, you know, be begging for a job. And I want to tell you that there are many numerous potential, you know, that a graduate of this student, you know, can benefit from after graduation. For our top official, in fact, I was a doctor, a lecturer in this department, in my department, you know, her name is a consultant, you know, in fishery and aquaculture, help people to manage their fish farm. And he also has a fish farm. I see a lecturer talk of apiaculture, that is a culture of bees. Bees are insects. You know, you can, yes, people do bee culturing and they like, but when a graduate of zoology knows how to do it better. I was talking of agrochemicals, you know, production of a bio-friendly or eco-friendly, you know, chemicals, yes. You know, to deal with it. You know, many people are going to agriculture and they need insecticide, you know, to kill, you know, pests, especially insect pests. So if you love, you can stand on it and say, okay, I want to be, because you understand the biology of insects. You know what insects, you know, will be susceptible to. Just producing chemicals, you know. There are also, you know, good products from animals that are of medical, you know, importance. And you know, some people are working on fish oil, you know, getting, you know, materials from fish that could be, you know, that could be used, you know, medically, you know, in agricultural setting and so on.
Yes, sir. Another thing I'd like to talk about, sir, from your comments earlier, the issue of earth development in the country. What is the contribution of animal and environmental biology to the overall development of health in Nigeria?
Thank you very much for that question. You see, when I started, I stated the branches, sub-branches under this program. You see, if you look critically, every of the branch, has one or two relationship with health. Talk of environmental biology. Healthy environment gives you, good health.
Mm-hmm.
You study pollution, you study the relationship between waste and human health. Talk of parasitology, studying of animals that are microscopic but that are inimical, that are harmful, to human health.
Okay.
You study their control, what is their spread like, what are probable measures that could be put in place, to mitigate their spread and all of this. And even develop, diagnostics. That's what I do now. I develop diagnostics, for some of these infections. If you are able to, detect an infection, you've started, controlling that infection. So you find that genetics, gene therapy and all the like, all of these are, related, to health.
Thank you very much, Dr. Oyeyemi. If you are just joining us, we've been talking about animal and environmental biology on this edition of UNIMED Career Updates. Stay tuned, the program continues in a moment.
We are the School of Public Health Without War, Nigeria's first full-fledged school of public health. Located in Ondo City, Ondo State, the School of Public Health of the University of Medical Sciences, UNIMED, bridges the gap between classroom learning and the field. Our faculty with deep knowledge of public health is our pride.
I'm Professor Olumide Ogudawose. I bring to bear my decades-long experience in public health working in the WHO.
Our goal is to build one of the best schools of public health in the world in the shortest time possible. And we are right on track towards achieving our target.
UNIMED School of Public Health offers courses such as Postgraduate Diploma in Public Health, Masters of Public Health, Masters of Science in Public Health, Doctor of Public Health, Doctor of Philosophy in Public Health. For more, visit www.unimed.edu.ng.
Medical Sciences, UNIMED, in Ondo City, Ondo State, is not just the first specialized medical and health sciences university in Nigeria.
It is the best ground for training in the health profession and medical sciences with outstanding products.
I had to enroll at another institution before coming to UNIMED, and I can tell you, in terms of facility, affordable cost, uninterrupted academic calendar, University of Medical Sciences blew my mind.
In just 7 years of its founding, the National Universities Commission, NUC, ranks UNIMED best among medical and health sciences university in Nigeria, fourth best state university, and 19th overall best in Nigeria in 2021. UNIMED, proudly Nigeria's first specialized medical and health sciences university.
Glad to have you back. If you are just joining us, you've been watching UNIMED Career Updates. This is a program that showcases various courses of the University of Medical Sciences, UNIMED, Ondo. And we still have in the studio Dr. Oyeyemi. So the program we are talking about, Animal and Environmental Biology, is domiciled in the Faculty of Science, UNIMED. Can you tell us more about the career opportunities in this faculty, sir?
Yeah, before I talk about the career opportunities in the faculty, it is important for us to know the other programs that are domiciled in the faculty. For example, my program is domiciled within the Department of Biological Sciences. And in Biological Sciences, we have microbiology, we have plant biology and biotechnology. And the word biotechnology, of course, the word is being biotechnology. So having, biotechnology to solve a lot of, issue, whether health or environment and the like. Microbiology, study of microorganisms, and we know COVID-19 is a microorganism. So you know, have knowledge about microbiology, you would maybe call by any body in the world to come and help us solve, infectious diseases problem. Another pandemic is still coming, whether we like it or not. So talk of physics, we have physics, also Department of Physics. Physics, we have medical physics and physics electronics in that field. And medical physics, we have medical sciences that people know that are furnished with knowledge of medical equipment,
okay.
How it works, you know, talking of S3 and the like, you know, these people can work even in hospital because, you know, of that fit. Talk of chemistry. We have chemistry. We have information science. You know, we have SLT. This is a very important program.
SLT, we mean?
Science, Laboratory, Technology.
Okay.
You know, having different, you know, programs like a computational biology, have SLT in biochemistry, SLT in microbiology, and so on. And all of these, you know, they have, you know, important, you know, contribution they can, you know, render to this society.
Okay, sir. Very soon, the form for post UTME of the university will be out, I understand. Sir, can you tell us why will a student or a candidate choose to study at the University of Medical Sciences, maybe instead of another university?
Thank you very much for that important question. You see, it is obvious, it's not against saying no. So, you see, of all, let's first of all see, of all the universities in Ondo State, UNIMED is the only university currently on session.
Okay.
You talk of, you know, stable academic calendar, you know, UNIMED is committed to that. As a matter of fact, members of academic staff, we have zero, we don't like strike, that's just the truth. You know, and we expect that if you come in for a four-year program, you should graduate in 4 years. And talk of a state-of-the-art facilities we have to train our students. You know, they are not, you know, we have a lot of facilities, you know, that even the so-called, many of the so-called first-generation universities come down to our university to carry out some analysis. And our faculty members, also department, are also even working, you know, making more effort to even get more facilities, you know, to train our students. So we have the facilities, stability, and also student-lecturer relationship is so cordial. You know, we take our students like our brothers, like our children. So there is this mutual, you know, relationship, you know, healthy relationship between lecturers and students at the University of Medical Sciences.
Let's talk about money here, sir. Cost of these programs. What will the students be expected to pay, for example, to come and study your program, Animal and Environmental Biology?
I won't only talk about my program, Faculty of Science,
okay,
generally, because we pay the same school fees.
Okay.
I want to assure you that our school fees is less than 300,000. But for indigene of Ondo State, they currently pay 154,000.
154,000 naira only.
Only. Why non-indigene pay 174,000?
Okay.
So don't be confused by, when you hear UNIMED, you think it's a million. So Faculty of Science, our school fees is bearing and it's comparable to whatever is obtainable in other universities you know, around. Of course, much more, you know, lower than the private university, or you can't compare it.
Dr. Oyeyemi, tell us more about the admission requirements. Students will soon be applying to the university for the post UTME screening.
Thank you for that question. In order to gain admission into the program, Animal and Environmental Biology, a candidate seeking for admission must have, you know, credit pass in 5 major subjects,
okay,
including English and mathematics, physics, chemistry, and biology, you know, at 1 or 2 sittings. Then for UTME, a minimum of 180 JAMB score.
Okay.
Then, of course, after that, the candidate will be required to write a post UTME, and the student must at least, to be on the safer side, have at least 50%, you know, aggregate score from post UTME and UTME.
Okay.
So with that, the student is guaranteed admission to, you know, the program.
Thank you, sir. Let me come back to the accreditation of these programs. We can start from your own department, sir. How far with the accreditation status?
Yeah, currently we have full accreditation for biological sciences, including my program, Animal and Environmental Biology. We were resourced, you know, verified in 2017 and 2019. We had a full accreditation for our programs.
So full accreditation will be out
for 5 years.
For 5 years. So candidates coming in can be rest assured
that
there is a full accreditation
for our courses.
How about other programs?
For other programs is Faculty of Science presently. All our programs, except SLT that was just introduced, you know, recently.
Okay.
You know, we already have full accreditation for all our programs. And for SLT, I'm very sure that the accreditation for that is short, because we have more than enough facilities to, you know, for that program. For all the programs in the Faculty of Science presently, we have accreditation for that.
Tell us about your own program, Animal and Environmental Biology. What's your take about this program? Do you enjoy this?
I'm enjoying it.
Okay.
Because I wouldn't know what other course I would have loved to study if I didn't study Animal and Environmental Biology, because it has opened.
Would you like to study medicine?
Yes, initially I loved to study medicine then, but after some times I just pick interest, even when I had the opportunity of going back to study. Before, I was offered admission to study dentistry at OEU, but I just jettisoned it and I said I think I saw light in this course, and I've been pursuing it since then. Though people don't see the potential, but they agree that I'm in it. Know that because it opens you to a wide world of opportunity. No, as a biologist, as an animal and environmental biologist, I have virtually knowledge in all fields of science, and that connects me to many opportunities. You have knowledge in anatomy, in physiology, in biochemistry, in microbiology, in pharmacology. So it has opened, you know, I've enjoyed a lot of opportunities just because, you know, I study animal and environmental biology.
You know why that question is very important, sir? Many people applying to the university always think of the number one course is medicine. Nursing, maybe dentistry, and a few others. Now we have all these programs, so people would like to know if actually you can find fulfillment doing this program.
Let me tell you one thing. I wanted to be a medical doctor initially, but later I found out that if I've been a medical doctor, I love medicine, and anyone that studies medicine, good luck. No issue for that. But no issue with that. But the truth is that, you know, I found myself even doing, you know, contributing to medical feed through my course. Because now I'm working on detecting, you know, diagnostic kits for certain, diseases. You know, I'm working on, knowing, you know, how much of a population is being affected with certain, you know, parasitic infection, parasitology.
Yeah.
And also, you know, giving, formulating policy, you know, for government, you know, recommendation, you know, working with the Ministry of Health, you know, to solve, society problem, health issue.
Yeah.
So it's not all about medicine. It's not about any, if you have interest in health, you know, you can find fulfillment in this course. I have interest in health, and I'm doing much more in contributing to the well-being of the society.
It's been nice having you on this edition of UNIMED Career Updates, Dr. Oyeyemi.
Thank you very much.
That is going to be the size of this edition of UNIMED Career Updates.
For information on admissions, please call Ms. Fumbila Dapo on 0813-5513-654. Again, 0813-5513-654. Or send a mail to admissions@unimed.edu.ng. Again, admissions@unimed.edu.ng. For comments on the program, send a mail to media@unimed.edu.ng. Until next week, when I be coming your way with another interesting version of the program, my name is Lemi Tokwe Uluwatayo. Bye for now.